Good morning. I'm Bee Nimble, and I'm here with a load of sarcasm. We are here in Lancaster, Pennsylvania, at the 2019 WFTDA North American Cup East. We have a great game for you starting this morning.
Yeah, we do. You never want to sleep in the first game of the day. That's what I've learned in postseason from all these years.
And the beautiful thing is actually the two teams that are playing, which is Tampa and Tri-City, are one rank away from each other. Tampa is currently ranked on WFTDA.stats.com at 52 and Tri-City at 53.
I'm looking forward to this. I came in a little sleepy, but I think I'm going to be wide awake once everything starts.
Yeah, and both teams are sort of getting started right now. These teams have never played each other before, so this is going to be their first matchup with some pretty high stakes.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. So we can go ahead and intro the teams here if you want. Do you want to start us off?
I would love to. I'm going to tell you who is playing today for Tri-City Roller Derby. We have number 11, Superstack. Number 20, Dangerous. Like dangerous, but dangerous. I like that. 2042, Agrosaurus. 24, Animal. 25, Smack Kerouac. 266, Ashley Devaney. 303, Violet No Regard. I like that one too. 333, Poison Eevee. 42, Megan Plead. 58, Slasquatch. 6, Christy Henderson. 64, Cannonball Doll. 71, Maggie Middleton. 84, Megantron. And 95, Hannah Ferrer.
All right, and so Tampa Roller Derby, Tampa Tantrums. We've got 021, we have Reject. Number 04, Blue Storm. 090, Rude. 112, Tink. 18, Slam Witch. Number 2, PH Diesel. 357, Felony Fat Bottom. 41, Amber Lou. 424, Zombie. Number 50, Rojo Grande. 66, Sugar and Spice. 81, D-Ride. 83, Break Some Bones. Number 9, Wasilku. And number 2, Trip McNeely.
And while we have a little bit of time, it makes a lot of sense for us to tell you who will be officiating this game. Our officials for Game 1 today, Tampa versus Tri-City, is Bippity Boppity Boom, M Power, Wifeopathic Signals, Epic Phil, Jeremy Jones, Rhea Culpa, Chris Brace, the alt is Adam Smasher.
And then we've got Trogdora the Jaminator, Burt Hurt, TBD, Taboma, Bad Wolf Archer, Slammerus, Boptimus Prime, Shonuff, Diamond Tierra, and Big Brad Wolf.
And we are about 1 minute away from beginning this first North American East Cup playoff. This is Tri-City's first postseason appearance since 2016, where they were at Division Twos. And last year, Tampa chose not to play in the 2018 postseason. So for both of these teams, this is their first postseason in a while.
And you would say this is also going to be the first time that these two teams have come across one another to put some skates on the track and points into the archives.
Interesting fact is I believe Tri-City also hosts what was formerly Beaver Fever. Is now Put Your Toques Up, up in near Toronto.
All right, so
we're counting down right now.
Yep.
Both teams are on the track here. We have number 84, Megantron, jamming for Tri-City, and that's number 2, PH Diesel, jamming for Tampa.
All right, 5 second call there.
Tampa has the back line. Obviously, four blockers strong here for both teams to start the night, day, morning.
Very early.
Very early morning.
All right, so PH Diesel up front. Ooh. And looks like Megantron there being held in the back, recycled back behind the jam line.
Yeah, Break Some Bones, 83, was able to get Megantron out of bounds and pull her back just a bit. And again, that's 92, I believe. Trip McNeely. The pack is spreading out. There is a bridge being dropped by Tri-City here as number 2, the jammer for Tampa, PH Diesel strings the pack out but gets knocked to the inside.
Inside, that's going to be a big recycle there. Back to about the, jam line. So we're just about a minute in, and the pack has not advanced past turn one here at all. So it looks like that's going to be PH Diesel being sent to the penalty box for a back block.
That's right. So this is a great opportunity here for Tri-City to play some offense to get their jammer out and lead because, of course, even though we're so far in, nobody has been declared lead or gotten out of the pack yet.
Tri-City having lost their pivot, rather, to the penalty box.
And still, Tampa defense just locking it in here on Megantron.
Speaking of PH Diesel, out of the penalty box and now making your way to the back of the track there as everyone waits for right in the back of the front, the back of the track.
Currently, there's only 15 seconds left in this jam, but of course, the Tampa jammer is not eligible for lead because she did go to the box. So there is no lead jammer, but Tampa is scoring points here.
And knockout to the inside right there as the whistle blows at the two-minute mark.
What a way to start.
Yeah.
A full 2 minutes, 2 points, no lead. Wow.
Yeah, that's a lot of defense there from Tampa being able to hold Megantron back. Really not able to get into turn three at all in the full 2 minutes.
Yeah.
Up next, we've got number 18 in the black for Tampa. That's Slamwich.
And it's number 333. That is Poison Eevee for Tri-City. Tri-City taking the back wall here, maybe trying to do something a little different than the last time. Poison Eevee also knocked to the outside by actually one and then two blockers.
Yeah, that was a double hit right there. Really kind of thought she was going to take the outside of the front stretch there. This time around, she's going to get kind of slide out at the jammer line. We've got Tampa Slamwich picking up lead jammer.
However, about a half a track behind is the Tri-City jammer approaching quickly. There is a couple of blockers in the box.
Slamwich is going to go ahead and call it off in the pack.
We're going to look to the officials to see 3 points.
All right, so Tampa's going to have 5 points here. Tri-City held scoreless for the second jam in a row, just about 4 minutes into this game, game one of the 2019 WFTDA North American Cup East.
Both packs are going to start here with three blockers on the track, each having one blocker in the box to start here.
Tink from Tampa in the black taking on Ashley Deveni there in the red for Tri-City.
And it is basically just one giant pack there.
Yeah, the first two jams, we had really seen them kind of like divide and separate out. But this time around, you're absolutely correct, B. It's just a mash of people there slowly moving into turn one.
Both blockers have been released from the box, so both teams have a full contingency on the track now.
We've got everyone in turn one. That is Ashley in the back with Tri-City and Tink with just a couple of feet preference there over Ashley. But it's going to be Tink picking up lead jammer once again, back-to-back lead jammers for Tampa.
And what I'm seeing here is if Tampa can get the Tri-City blockers moving, it seems, you know, maybe if they send one offensive person up to get them moving, it seems like that's where they're having the success in getting their jammer out.
All right, so we've got a scoring trip there already in the books for Tink, coming around and meeting the pack in turn four. She's going to take it to the inside line. Looks like just one to beat. Some great recycling there by Tri-City up front, but Tink is through for a second.
And the jammer for Tri-City has removed the helmet cover and I believe, has passed it to the pivot.
All right, so Dangerous, the jammer of record for Tri-City. Tink into turn two, looking for another scoring pass. This would complete a third, and she does coming into turn three.
She looks over to her coach to see what to do.
All right, and it looks like that's going to be another two-minute jam. So a huge 12-point jam there for Tampa. Just 2 points on the board in the first jam, but they've really put the points up there. Tampa 17, Tri-City 0, 7 minutes in.
Tampa's putting number 021 on the track as jammer. Who is that? Do we have
them? Yep, it's a rehab reject. And no denying that is number 24, Animal, out there for Tri-City. Love that large number.
Yes. A lot of some tumbling here. Tampa, though, able to secure. No, I'm sorry. That is a forearm call on Tampa's jammer. So it is a power jam for Tri-City. Let's see if they can do a little bit more than they did in that first power jam opportunity they had.
Yeah, that's crazy when you think that this is the second power jam that Tri-City had. But let's remember the first one. In the first jam, they weren't able to put any points on the board. Their jammer just held back the entire time by Tampa's strong defense. And it looks like Animal's going to just fall into the same situation here. Sizable hits there coming out of turn two.
Yeah, Tri-City holding trying a different strategy here, holding a blocker back. This jammer is not lead, even though they have escaped, escaped the pack on a first scoring pass here. So there will be no lead, actually, in this jam again.
All right, so we've got rehab reject out of the penalty box, and it looks like that completes her initial there.
And Shirley, I believe that Animal probably has a couple of points in her pocket here to put Tri-City on the board, but to no avail, rehab reject is on another scoring pass here.
Yeah, exactly. Whatever Animal has in her pocket, we definitely have points up there for rehab reject. And as you said, coming in for a second scoring pass here into turn four.
A couple of whistles here. We'll see.
Rehab reject going to take it to the back of, taking it to the inside from the back of the pack.
That was a direction of gameplay on number two. And then an in-sub, actually, because we did hear the whistle go at least three times. So a Tri-City blocker will be sitting in the box for a whole minute, really.
All right. So previous jam, Tampa had 12 points on the board. This time around, it's eight. So Tampa 25 to Tri-City 4 points. Those 4 points coming in this jam here, jam four. And we're about 9 minutes into the first game of the day.
Relatively low scoring despite two power jams for Tri-City, but both teams pretty low scoring so far. That is a lead for Tampa again.
Yeah, Felony Fat Bottom, number 357, wearing the star for Tampa in the black, takes it around to the outside of turn one to put 4 points up for Tampa.
Barely touched on the outside there. That was lovely.
Yeah.
And just of note, this is the fifth different jammer for Tampa, so they're showing some depth to their bench here. And, of course, this is a playoff weekend, and so the more legs you can have, the better.
Wait, you can have more than two legs?
Well, you know what I mean. The
The
more...
All right, so...
The more sharing of the jammer...
Responsibilities.
Yes.
All right.
And athleticism and endurance, all of those things is what I meant by legs.
Got it. Felony Fat Bottom putting 12 points on the board. That is matching the highest scoring jam so far that I believe came in jam three. So Tampa now 37. Tri-City held scoreless again at 4:10 in.
We have one... We have Dangerous standing in the box again. Had that 1 minute for an in-sub after a... direction of gameplay.
PH Diesel wearing the star for Tampa and out lead jammer once again for Tampa. They're just really burning this lead jammer status here up this morning. Calling it off this time around, not running it out too long.
Yeah, that was a quick four.
Yeah, Tri-City, though, jammer probably escaping as fast as just about any we've seen so far.
Yep.
So those 4 points for Tampa will bring them to 41.
And honestly, if Tri can get out sooner and hold them to those four-point jams, we could see a shift here. This is an official timeout being called.
I believe we've got some reads here for the day, for the weekend. You want to share one of those?
We do. We have Rydell Skates, who I'm gonna just throw it out there. That is the skate that I use. I love my Solarises. They're the innovative leader in roller skates for over 70 years. They make their skates with custom colors, handcrafted in their color lab. I'm sure you've seen skaters with super flashy, beautiful skates. The 2019 WFTDA Continental Cups are brought to you by the popular, gave a plug here, Rydell Solaris, the performance you demand and the comfort you've been missing. I love mine.
All right, so it looks like we are back at it. This time around, we've got the pack coming up real close to the jam line. It looks like number 18, Slamwich, getting low for Tampa in the black. Taking it straight up the middle and pushing that pack up forward. That's Poison Evie there for Tri-City, wearing the star in red.
Yeah. A Tampa blocker knocked one of the Tri-City blockers out of bounds there and was able to draw a track cut penalty, which, if you're Tampa, you know, any fewer blockers on the track that your jammer has to beat is offense, essentially.
So we've got Slamwich picking up a lead jammer privilege here for Tampa. And that first scoring pass was beautiful. It was just, she skated through the pack like she had a force field around her. Nobody touched her. I don't even know, a cloak of invisibility, because there was no way that anyone saw her. She just went through so smooth. So it looks like a total of 8 points this time around for Tampa. That's going to bring them to 49, Tri-City 4.
Yeah, we are about... We're close to the halfway point of this first half. Again, Tri-City really just struggling to get out of the pack and score points. Tampa has demanded and controlled lead jammer status so far.
All right, so we've got Tink wearing the star for Tampa with a quick release. She started back there well behind turn four, so came into the whistle with a bit of speed and used that to just pick up lead jammer within a few seconds. So she's coming around for a scoring pass. The pack is waiting there for her in turn two. We've got Anna Maldo, number 24, also out of the pack. A quick call off, but not before Tink is able to put up three more points.
And I think Anna Maldo, that's the second time, has been able to get out and force that four-point call off. So I don't know. They might look at that matchup and see if there's something that they can keep doing to just keep Tampa from scoring those 8-12-point jams.
All right, so number 021, Rehab Reject for Tampa. Megan Tron, number 84, wearing the star for Tri-City. Megan Tron looking to take it to the outside of the front stretch. Gets denied. This time around, going to take it to the inside. And will get knocked out of bounds in the midway part between 1 and 2. In the meantime, Rehab Reject still pushing the pack forward into the back stretch. Tiptoeing along the inside, picks up lead yet again. We're in jam 9. How many times has Tampa picked up lead?
Tampa has had, including this one, 7 leads in 9 jams, and two jams had no lead at all.
And we see Tri-City using the star pass again to get their jammer out. That is dangerous. This time around, wearing the star, Rehab Reject going to take it to the inside of turn 4 and call it off
for
with another 3 points.
So what we saw in that last jam was dangerous taking the star, and she has received 19 star passes this season as pivot on 192 jams.
Two so far.
And yeah, that's twice today, right? So we're just going to add to that pretty quickly, I would imagine. So 266, Ashley DeVenny wearing the star for red in Tri-City.
A little combo. We have an official reserve here by Tri-City Rollers. We will get to you as soon as we know exactly what's going on. We have a spy in the midst of that circle. Not really.
And by spy, you just mean
yeah.
The alt ref.
Yes.
Who- is an incredibly important role and one that announcers just really appreciate.
So very much. And that's Adam Smasher for this particular bout. It's a good opportunity right now. We're at 15:59, almost exactly the midway point for both teams to sort of regroup, talk to one another. Tri-City probably needs to think about shaking things up a little bit, see if they can get some points on the board before halftime.
All right, so it looks like we're going to turn it over to the head ref here. All right, so it looks like it's obviously Tri-City's official review, and they're looking for a forearm call on, is it PH Diesel?
Yes. So the official.
Or was it the jammer?
Right.
Well, you know what? We're going to get details on our alt ref, Adam Smasher. No sense guessing when we're going to have some information sooner rather than later.
That is absolutely true.
So, yeah, so we talked before things really got started that this matchup was going to be something else. We have, coming in the 8 and 9 seed here, Tri-City Roller Derby coming in 9 and Tampa coming in 8. Tampa ranked 52 and Tri-City 53, so incredibly close. But, you know, we're only 9 jams in, but just seeing a lot of power and a lot of solid defense from Tampa. Being able to control the pack. So we're going to go back out to the head ref here.
...have concluded that the forearm call was not merited and the review will not be retained.
They were looking for it on rehab reject.
All right, so, yep, it was rehab reject that they were looking for that forearm call on. And I believe you could all hear that. We got the head ref, I believe, in the feed here, so you should be able to hear that. So the official review lost by Tri-City.
And we're off again. I will say I did watch some footage of Tampa earlier this season, and Tri-City able to scooch through on the inside.
And that's the first time that Tri-City has picked up lead jam so far, 10 jams in. They've only been able to put points up on the board twice. And here we are. First time they picked up lead, 4 points.
Nearly untouched, actually, by that super effective Tampa defense. And this brings me to what I was going to say. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, this time around, a quick hop of the inside of turn one. Great job by Poison Ivy to pick up another 4 points.
Yeah, and they are doubling, tripling their score at this point. One of Tampa's blockers is in the box, so only 3 to beat here. But what I was going to say earlier is that some of the footage that I watched of Tampa is that they started off super strong and lost some momentum right at about this point. So this could be a really great opportunity for Tri-City to not only score points, but get back in this game.
All right, so we've just got a standstill there in the backstretch. Neither jammer really moving at all. We've got Felony Fat Bottom passing the star off now to Zombie. So really seeing that opportunity to stop things here where they are. Poison Ivy able to pick up lead jammer for Tri-City for the first time in 10 jams.
But also,
12 points on the board, which, matches the highest scoring jam so far in the game, and we've seen that twice so far from Tampa. Next lineup here, it's number 266, Ashley DeVenny, taking on number 2, that's PH Diesel.
And we should mention that that 12-point jam for Tri-City is the first time they have held Tampa scoreless in a jam. Oh, that was a tiptoe right on the inside line for PH Diesel.
Yeah, that was a quick answer back to those 12 points and the lead jammer that Tri-City picked up. Looks like we've got a star handoff there.
Yep.
Going to Dangerous once again.
Mm-hmm. So that's 3 this. That's the 4th pass to Dangerous. Puts the star on the cap. Going to force Tampa to call it off with 3 points.
All right, so those 3 points from Tampa, that's going to bring them to 58. They held scoreless in the last jam. Tri-City, though, held scoreless this time at 16. We've got 13 minutes left to go in the first game of the day.
And that might be there. That might tie. So scoreless in two jams ago, three in the last jam. That might be, I think the three is the least they've scored maybe during the first two. Okay.
Yep. Yeah, and you're right. It was the first jam where they picked up two to start things off. So we've got Slamwich in black wearing the star for Tampa. Megatron wearing it for Tri-City in red. We're seeing that pack just really bunch up there in the front stretch, but a sweet roll off the pack to the outside for Slamwich is going to pick up lead, bringing it back to Tampa.
Megatron has taken the star off of her helmet. The packs are drawn out a little bit.
Slamwich with a quick 4 points. And Megatron with the star off, but looks like just a star stash. Made her way out of the pack. Has completed an initial. We've got Slamwich in turn two with a hard knockdown coming out of turn two. We'll call it off from the floor.
At the very tail end of that, there was an out-of-play block called on one of the Tri-City blockers. I'm not sure who it was. It was Wasilku.
All right, so Tampa sitting at 66, Tri-City 16, just under 12 minutes left to go in the first half of the first game of the 2019 WFTDA North American Cup East, live from Lancaster, Pennsylvania. The host this weekend is Dutchland Derby Rollers and the WFTDA.
And just a correction on that, it was Smack Kerouac that went to the box on that out-of-play block.
And I'm all in the red, wearing the star for Tri-City. Tink, the jammer for Tampa. And it looks like Tink's going to pick up lead once again. But Animal, you talked about this earlier, really able to get out of the pack and put the pressure on. This is probably the most pressure a Tampa jammer has encountered so far this game.
Really beautiful offense played by the Tampa pivot.
And 2 points on the board for Tri-City. Animal just putting the afterburners on, chasing Tink, picking up 2 points. That's going to bring Tri-City to 18, Tampa at 70.
We have 11 minutes left in this half. Tri-City definitely kicking it up a notch here in the last five-ish minutes and able to put – they were sitting at four at 15 minutes, I believe, and now they are sitting at 18, of course, to Tampa's 70.
We've got Violet, no regard. It looks like first time wearing – I'm sorry, Poison Ivy, rather, wearing the star for Tri-City. Out picking up lead, just the second time that they've done that so far this game, and we're only 14 jams in.
But I believe it was Poison Ivy the last time as well.
Yeah.
Who scored those 12 points.
Yeah, the whistle blew. She took it straight to the outside of the front stretch and picked it up before turn one. So we've got a call off there from the pack. So it's 3 points on the board for Tri-City. It's going to bring them up to 21. Tampa held scoreless, 70. So taking a look at what we've got to start here, that looks like a pretty anemic group of blockers there for Tri-City. It looks like they've got two sitting in the box. So that's a good 10-plus seconds for Tampa to really make the most of it.
So far, if we're looking at the penalties, we see that Tri-City definitely winning that, and I don't mean that really like winning. Tri-City has, let's see, 3, 7, 9 penalties so far.
Yep.
4 on number 25, Smack Kerouac.
So we've got PH Diesel out with lead for Tampa, completing a second scoring pass with a quick couple of steps over the inside of turn two. We've got those Tri-City blockers back on the track at this point. PH Diesel approaching the pack in turn two yet again. Takes it to the outside and picks up an additional 4. 12 points on the board so far this jam for PH Diesel.
So that Tampa able to answer back here to some of Tri-City's bigger jams in the last couple. And the packs are drawing out here. We have a Tri-City bridge. PH Diesel able to score another four, and an out-of-play block, that drawn-out pack, certainly created that call on one of Tri-City's blockers.
PhDs is going to get pushed to the inside of turn three this time around. 16 points on the board. I keep saying on the board. I need, like, a little, like, shock here, suggest, or, like, kick
okay.
me or something.
All right.
So, yeah, 16 points so far. That's the highest scoring jam that we've seen in the game. We've had a handful of 12, a bunch of them from Tampa, but one up there for Tri-City. We've got another star pass being
this time
used by
not,
Tri-City.
This time not to Jandris. This time it went to Violet No Regard, who just really struggled getting out of that pack. So that's 20 points here for Tampa, widening that lead to 90 to Tri-City's 21. There are 7.5 minutes left in the first half. For the first time in a while, the box will be empty starting this jam.
All right, so we've got Poison Ivy wearing the star for Tri-City, who's had some great luck so far. The only jammer to pick up a lead jammer for Tri-City. She's going up against Slamwich for Tampa in the black. Slamwich is going to get recycled.
But Slamwich has also received 100% lead for Tampa today in three jams. So this is a good matchup here. Some offense being played at the front by Tri-City.
Well, you know, I've seen this so many times where it just comes down to a slow grind in the front stretch. But it's going to be Poison Ivy picking up lead jammer once again for Tri-City.
That's her third. Yeah, that's her third lead jam status, and a little apex jump. She lands it. Beautiful job. And the Tampa jammer is still stuck in the pack. So a second scoring pass on the horizon here for Poison Ivy.
Poison Ivy just yelling at her her team here.
Same
to
points.
Just kind of move. That's happening obviously off screen. She comes into the pack hard in turn three. Looks like. Not calling it off, still in the mix here.
Yep, and I'm looking right over at the Tri-City coach who's doing sort of the lasso movement, which just means run it. Slamwich has to call it, however, because a wheel fell off of her skate in the middle of that jam. Did I say Slamwich? I meant Poison.
Oh, well.
So
I mean, talk about a good run, and not that you want that to happen to any skater, but she's been able to just get out there and be so productive for Tri-City, picking up the only jammer to pick up lead, doing it three times, putting a significant amount of their 28 points out there. But now we've got Megan Tron picking up lead for Tri-City, so this is great.
Yeah, there's some momentum here. There's definitely some momentum. And we see the pit crew over on the bench fixing up Poison Ivy, getting that wheel back on. In the meantime, though, Tampa's jammer has gotten out. We'll see if any points go on the board. Three for Tri-City. That brings them to 31 points here with about 5 minutes left in this half. That's 93 for Tampa. Tri-City has used their official review. Tampa has not. And as I say this, as I was about to say, team has used a timeout. There has been a 10-0 run in the last two jams for Tri-City. So this is the first timeout called. There was an official review earlier that Tri-City lost. They were looking for a forearm. Of note, we've got a long day of derby ahead of us, and the winner of this game, of course, will move on to play at 6, and they'll play Naptown, who is seeded number 1 here this weekend. So whichever team, if Tri-City can keep this momentum and chip back away, or if Tampa can hold on to it, they have a formidable opponent later today.
Yeah, absolutely.
And whoever loses, of course, will play the winner or the loser of Ohio versus Madison. So we have a wonderful day of derby ahead of us. We are just getting things going here.
All right. So If you're taking a look at the screen here, you can obviously see Animal ready, poised and ready to go. But that was Tink off screen, well into turn four, doing just what she did last time, was just kind of step back and pull the momentum.
Oh. That was a 1-2. That was incredible. So Animal does a little bit of jammer on jammer action, able to knock down the Tampa jammer. Tink, of course. But then one of Tampa's blockers, I couldn't see their number, just leveled Animal out of bounds.
Yeah, it was just like a cascading bit of down jammers there coming out of turn two. But right now it looks like we are in turn three. We have Tink pushing forward on a brace tripod of Tri-City.
But, of course, neither jammer right now is scoring points. Sort of that kerfuffle that happened between turn two and three has made both jammers have to re-enter and fight back through all four blockers.
And so we've got Tink out, giving lead there. Hard-fought lead pickup coming out of turn four. Approaching the back of the pack here. In turn four, where she was just recently awarded lead. She's going to go down hard here on the outside.
Number 81, D-Rai, playing some good offense here for Tink, trying to at least neutralize one of the Tri-City blockers so that she only has three to beat.
Tink trying to roll off to one side or the other. Tries to take it straight up the middle, but eventually just finds purchase on the inside of turn one to pick up 4 points.
And that's, again, number 81, D-Rai, giving the business to Animal, who, after that really beautiful jammer-on-jammer takeout,
yeah,
has really struggled against a standstill of Tampa blockers.
So we've got the jam ended here. Tink with an additional, so it looks like 3 points in that trip, so 7 points total. That's going to bring Tampa to an even 100 points as we've got about 2.5 minutes left to go in the first half. Tri-City at 31.
And of course 70 points, 69 essentially, is a wide gap, but it's not insurmountable.
All right, this time around, Blue Storm for Tampa. That sounds like a new name
to
me.
Yeah, I think that's the first time that Blue Storm, which means that Tampa has put out, I think, seven different jammers in this first half.
So Blue Storm's going to find a quick opening there on the inside of turn two. Almost completed it, but was knocked out, recycled to turn one. Takes it to the outside of turn two to pick up lead. We've got Ashley DeVenny wearing the star for Tri-City.
Oh, she tries to slide on the inside, but meets up with a Tri-City.
And that's it. I was looking for Ashley there on the track, but she had pulled back so far, I think in an attempt to force the cut on Blue Storm. And I couldn't figure out where she was. She had skated back to the front stretch while everyone was there coming outside of turn two. It looks like Blue Storm, though, being sent to the penalty box on a cut.
And, you know, what a smart play there by Ashley DeVenny. Really, that was a heads-up sort of awareness, knowing that she had gotten that jammer out and was able to pull her all the way back.
Yeah, I had this moment of like, is that a star stash? Why don't I see her? And then I realized I looked up from the screen and saw, oh, she's right in front of me.
Well, and I think the same thing happened to Blue Storm. I think it was a little bit confusing because the star had come off the helmet. And it was hard to see who actually hit her out. So, again, just when a skater knows that they've done it, like, it's just great.
So it looks like Tri-City is losing Dangerous to the penalty box on a cut.
There's about 30 seconds difference between the jam clock and the period clock, so we will have one more jam here.
That sweet little hit there just before the whistle from Tri-City's blocker. Let me get that for you. Number six, Christy Henderson to take out Blue Storm there as she approached into turn three.
So far, as we sort of round out this first half of Derby, Tri-City was only able to score 5 points on three power jams. So a really beautiful defense by Tampa we've seen so far.
All right, so it looks like I heard the rolling whistle. So while everyone is out on the track ready to skate the next jam, it seems as though we are in halftime. So, wow.
Yes.
Tampa has come out so incredibly strong, picking up lead. I don't even know. We had a couple, I mean, think maybe four leads picked up by Tri-City in total. Three of them coming from Poison Ivy.
Yep.
And Poison Ivy putting a fair number of those Tri-City points on the board. But it's just been...
That was 22 points total for Poison Ivy.
Yep.
The high point scorer for Tampa is PH Diesel with 29. So between the two of them, you know, sitting pretty in the 20-point to 30-point range. Again, we have penalties. They're more clumped up for Tri-City. Tampa has spread out their penalties more. But again, number 25, Smack Kerouac, does have four, but was able to sit at four for probably half of that half.
Yep. So I think what we're going to do is we're going to let you get some coffee, get some breakfast, take a break, and we'll kind of come back in just a little bit. But keep in mind, we've got a lot to see here at Tampa with a really deep jammer bench. So stay tuned. All right. Welcome back, Derby fans. My name is Lotus Sarcasm. I'm here with B Nimble. And thank you for coming back to the second half here of the first game of the 2019 WFTDA North American Cup East, live from Lancaster, Pennsylvania, brought to you by the Dutchland Derby Rollers and the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. We saw a great first half from Tampa, really coming out strong. Six to seven jammers out there in their rotation. Strong defense as well. And I know you've got some stats for us.
Yeah, sure. So for Tampa, we have Tink with 100% lead jam on four jams. Not far behind, though, is Tampa's highest scorer with 75% lead. That is PH Diesel. Slamwich also has 75% lead. And so that's a little bit of the story here. On the Tri-City side, we have Poison Ivy with 60% lead, scoring most of their points at 22. Megantron getting lead once. And, you know, if you can't get lead, you can't score points, you can't win the game. And so what we saw in the second half there was that Tri-City increased their ability to get lead, score points, and if they can keep that trajectory going, this could be a great second half.
But we're really seeing from Tri-City, we've got Jandris taking the star a number of times already. Four times in the, I believe, the 14 jams that we've seen in the first half.
And we should mention that later today, and at every Continental Cup, there is a free game on Twitch.
Yep.
It's going to be game five today. I'm not 100% sure what time that is. I can look, though. It's at 6 o'clock, so it'll be the second to last game of the day. And again, anyone can log in to twitch.tv and watch for free.
Free is for me.
Well, I think, you know, I think it's a great way to get the sport to be seen a little bit more. And certainly, you know, roller derby is an expensive sport to play. And it's lovely to make affordable options for people.
Yep. I always like to share the Twitch games, the information with my family, you know, wherever they are. I'm like, do you want to see what we're doing on any given weekend? Check this out. So thanks to Twitch and putting that game up for free. That's the 6 o'clock game today. PH Diesel out there for Tampa, taking on Poison Ivy. Poison Ivy, that really productive jammer for Tri-City, but it's PH Diesel out of the pack first, picking up lead.
And we start the half at 108 for Tampa, 34 for Tri-City. Of course, that's changed a little bit right now because Tampa has just put four more points on the board.
Yeah, and those 4 points went up, you know, fairly easy. There are two Tri-City blockers in the pack. We had Evie escape the pack and put some pressure on PH Diesel.
Yeah, really nice hustle there by Evie to get out of the pack and force the four-point call-off, which we spoke about that a little bit earlier, that could be a real key for them, is to condense to... What I'm trying to say is to force those call-offs without multiple passes.
Mm-hmm. All right, Slamwich in the black for Tampa. That's a 2-66. Ashley Deveni for Tri-City in red.
And there is one Tampa blocker in the box, so a little bit of advantage here to Tri-City.
Packs have separated out, and that is Ashley moving Tampa up front. She's going to get knocked down and taken to the inside of the track and recycled.
A little swap there of Tampa blockers. One goes out of the box, one comes in. Tri-City able to secure lead.
So Ashley looking to make the most of this. And Slamwich still held in the pack, just able to escape, but escapes while cutting. So power jam in favor of Ashley, Deveni, and Tri-City.
Yeah, that was a little bit of a risky move there, obviously, for Slamwich. It did appear, and it was called, that she had gone out and came in front of one of the Tri-City blockers.
Ashley had that one to beat Rojo there, coming out of turn four. Has put 4 points on the board for Tri-City. I don't know if Tri-City has actually been in that position before where they had lead and a power jam in their favor. We've got Slamwich now standing while Ashley has everything in the middle of the backstretch. Pack really slowed down with Tampa's defense holding her back. Just all four blockers up there from Tampa, just relentless.
I actually think this is the first time that Tri-City has been able to score at all on a power jam. And it's the fourth one that Tampa has given up, I believe.
All right, so a Slamwich out of the pack, coming into turn four. But Ashley's going to go ahead and call it off. So 4 points on the board for Ashley and Tri-City. Tampa held scoreless here, the second jam of the second half. Tampa 112, Tri-City 42, 3 minutes in.
We have one blocker who's standing in the box. It's the pivot for Tri-City. That is, where is my... Violet Noregard, standing in the box.
Whistle blows, Tink comes in with a little bit of momentum. Doesn't get too far. We've seen that it works so well for her, where she just kind of comes in with a bit of speed at the whistle and is able to just roll off. But this time, really a hard stop there, just off the jammer line, with all of Tri-City blockers just holding her back.
And in the first half, I believe Tink often went against Annie Mall. And this is this is sort of a different setup. Megan Tron, of course, a different stature skater than Annie Mall.
Yep.
And so, I don't know, maybe this could pay off. Sort of switch it up, see if they can hold Tink, who of course did have 100% lead, back.
So Pack is moving into turn one now, well into turn one. That is Tink still looking to find her way out, but actually able to move the pack. So it's not that she is just stagnant there in a particular space. She's able to move Tri-City forward with a little bit of help from her blocker.
Yeah, some really active offense coming from number 66 on Tampa. But
that is Megan Tron seeing an opportunity, breaking free of those Tampa blockers and just taking it sweetly to the outside of turn three. I don't think anyone saw her, and just picked up lead once again for Tri-City.
And Tink, of course, this is the first time not able to secure lead for Tampa, has removed the star from her helmet and is being pulled all the way back by number 303, Violet Noregard. I do want to give props to Sugar and Spice, who was playing that incredible offense at the beginning for Tampa.
All right, so we have Violet Noregard sitting in the penalty box for Tri-City. And Megan Tron is there in turn two. Looks like she went ahead and called it off, put an additional 2 points on the board. So six so far. We've got Tri-City at 48. Tampa held scoreless 112, 6 minutes in.
And how many times have we gotten to say that? Not Tampa too many. Held scoreless, right? Tri-City has really come out swinging in this second half.
And their bench is here for it. Their bench coach just really in it. Low crouch, big clap, just on that last jam.
Yeah, I have coached against him. I actually really love him. It has been a 14-4 run to start the second half of it in favor of Tri-City. So that is a very different start.
Yep. All right, but Rehab Reject going to comes out of the pack first with a burst of speed, but a cut track being given to her there.
It was actually a charging call.
Oh, okay.
Which is one of the new with WFTDA calls. And there's some whistles blowing here. We're going to see another Tampa blocker going to the box. This is a great opportunity for Tri-City.
Animal picking up a lead jammer for Tri-City.
And, of course, this is the second time that they have had a power jam in this second half.
Yeah, you just talked about that 14-4 run so far in the second half, but Animal is poised to add to that. She's got a lot of blockers there from Tampa just kind of waiting for her. Big help, though, from looks like number Agrosaurus coming in and just pushing out Tampa.
And, of course, Tri-City is lead here. The Tampa jammer is out. They're going to try and score some points before calling it off. We'll see how many go up.
Yeah, Animal was getting the big call off from the bench. Very well timed. That coach just eagle eye on Rehab Reject. So two more points will add to a total of 6 for Tri-City. That's going to bring them to 54. Tampa 112, 8 minutes in.
And we have seen Tampa going to the box quite a bit so far this second half. So
yeah, second power jam.
But Tri-City does have 2 blockers with 4. That is number 25 and number 303. Violet No Regard and Smack Kerouac.
Blue Storm, we've seen her once in the first half, now back again in the second. She picked up a cut last time she was out. She's going up against Poison Ivy, who's going to take a hard hit there in the front stretch and backed up. Poison Ivy, such a productive jammer here for Tri-City so far, picking up lead more often than anyone else. But it is Blue Storm out with lead again for Tampa. A quick break. Ivy with the star off out of turn one. Puts it back on, and it's just really closing that gap up there. Blue Storm in the midst of that pack, unable to see the bench and get the quick call off.
What a move! I love it.
2 points for each jammer.
That was a beautiful duck move on the outside by Evie. And able, of course, to sneak those 2 points, making it a 2-2 jam. Wow, I really loved that.
All right, so Tampa at 114, Tri-City 56, 9 minutes in. Ashley DeVenny wearing the star for Tri-City, taking on number 2, PH Diesel. Diesel's got the back of the pack, and Ashley pushed out of bounds to the outside, backed up by number 9 to turn 4. They're going to face off each other.
So the pack kind of got spread out there. It's reforming. Both jammers really, it's a physical pack in there.
PH Diesel around that last Tri-City blocker picks up lead.
And the helmet cover has come off for Ashley DeVenny. Was looking for her pivot, and Tampa was doing everything they could to make sure that they remained separated.
All right, PH Diesel pushing forward in the backstretch. It looks like Ashley, though, with the star off, is able to make a quick escape from the pack. Got the star back on as PH Diesel is pushed out of bounds in turn 3. Both jammers going to approach the pack there. In turn 3, it looks like PH Diesel recycled back a bit.
Yeah, and I'd assume that they're running this because there are 2 blockers in the box for Tampa. So likely trying to at least spring one of them before calling it so they have a stronger pack to start the next jam.
So there we go. We've got PH Diesel with lead jammer privilege is going to go ahead and call it off. But while she had 4 points, I'm kind of waiting for her as she called it off. We also had Tri-City and Ashley putting 4 points on. So a 4-4 pass. Both of those Tampa blockers that you were talking about are still starting in the box. So they've just got a handful of seconds left to go.
And again, I believe this is our second gym in a row that both teams have scored the same number of points. I believe it was 2 in the last jam and then 4 in this one. So 0-0 essentially in the last two jams.
Poison Ivy doing it again.
You are clapping.
Yes, excited. I just love her style. So quick out of the pack, the inside of turn one. This time is going to take it nice and low as she approaches into turn one here again. That outside just works for her. Taking it to turn two, gets knocked out, and will be recycled back.
And let's just remind folks who are listening, these two teams, and watching, are only one ranking point away. Tampa at 52, Tri-City at 53. And really, we've seen in this second half the game we expected.
Yeah. The first game with just such a large spread between these two teams. Upwards of 60, maybe 70 points with Tampa coming in strong. But things have really changed for Tri-City. They came out of the second half very strong. Evie there, still trying to make her way out of turn one, will call it off, had picked up 4 points before putting an end to the jam.
Smart move to sort of swing her hips around to ensure that she got all the points on that jam. And let's talk about momentum. Really strong momentum here coming into the second half for Tri-City. And momentum speaks volumes, you know, a little bit here, a little bit there, gaining lead, gaining 4 points. I do want to let you know that we are promoting concussion awareness. I think it's incredibly important. Do you know the symptoms of a concussion and the return to play protocol? And your teammates should be following it, too. You can visit the WFTDA.com/concussions for resources and information on this silent injury. The WFTDA has released new concussion risk clarifications on how to manage concussion risk before, during, and after a game. And you can find these and more resources at the WFTDA.com/concussions. As we come out of that timeout, it's been a 30 points to 10 run in the second half for Tri-City.
All right, so getting ready to take on the whistle. Megan Tron in the red for Tri-City and Rehab Reject wearing the star for Tampa. Tampa with one blocker in the box. Almost looked like we had Rehab Reject playing a little bit of defense to knock Megan Tron kind of off her skates there, but it's Megan Tron holding on, picking up lead jammer again for Tri-City.
Yeah, guess what? It didn't work.
Yeah, exactly. Nice try, but Tri-City has just been on it this second half, picking up lead more this half in 8 jams than they have the entire first half.
Yeah. And that was two additional points there picked up. And again, sure, only 2 points, but guess what? They got lead. And so then that can get in the other team's head, especially coming out this strong. We are at 118 for Tampa, 66 Tri-City. We're about 13 minutes in to this second half.
Animal in red taking on Felony Fat Bottom. It's Animal outside of turn one and then a quick break to the inside. Picks up lead once again for Tri-City.
So there's a couple things going on here. Number one, Tampa's going to the box more, which has created better opportunities for Tri-City. And that's a track cut on Tampa. It's going to be another power jam.
What you've done.
Felony Fat Bottom headed to the box as the jammer for Tampa. Tri-City securing lead, securing for 4 points, and coming around on another scoring pass here.
Yeah, so we talked about Tri-City being able to pick up lead so often this time, but this is also, I think, the third time that they've had lead during a power jam. So they really are controlling the game right now. We've got Felony Fat Bottom just standing as Animal is in turn two.
So there are two blockers for Tampa in the box. The jammer has just been released. This is such a great opportunity here for Tri-City to score multiple passes because, of course, now Felony Fat Bottom has to get through all of those Tri-City blockers again.
And, you know, Felony's just having a hard time. She just got quickly nicked here on the outside of turn four, tried to break it into the inside, and was denied there as well. So she's just completed an initial pass. Animal in the thick of things, calling it off, putting an additional 1 point. So Tampa scoreless yet again in the second half. Tri-City able to put 9 points on the board, 75-18. 15 minutes left to go.
I'm not sure how long Tampa has sat at 118, but it feels like a bit of time.
Yeah.
And number nine now has five penalties for Tampa. Can you tell me who that is?
With Silku.
And Tri-City able to remain pretty clean this half. They've had six power jams.
Poison Evie picking up lead jammer again for Tri-City. She comes out of turn three with such a smile on her face. Takes it nice down and low. The outside of turn one for four more points for Tri-City.
And two blockers in the box for Tampa here. So a difficult pack for Tampa, and an easy way to get through for Poison Evie.
Easy Evie taking it to the inside of the backstretch, meeting the pack at the same time. This time, nice and low outside of turn four. Oh, my goodness. I need no more caffeine for the rest of the day because I am high on Poison Evie this second half.
You know what? Tri-City is showing some great character here. I'm loving it. 88 points. That was 12 that matches. There was a 20-point jam at one time, but there's been several 12-point jams, and Poison Evie just adds to, I think that's her second 12-point jam. Yep.
All right, so Megan Tron out there for Tri-City in the red, looking to take it to the inside, but gets denied by number 83, yes. That is Break Some Bones. We've also got Blue Storm out there. Third time so far. Picked up lead the last time she was out here in the second half.
Yeah, and for the first time in a while, Tampa has all four blockers on the track. The packs are split up. Megan Tron, of course, fighting at the back.
All right, so it's just kind of like we're taking a breath, watching things happen. We've got Tampa with one of their blockers rolling off to the penalty box, and a second jammer rolled off to the penalty box. Megan Tron with lead coming out of turn two. Pack speed seems to be moving a little bit quicker here. We've got Blue Storm out of the pack as well. Megan Tron about a half track ahead of Blue Storm, but Blue Storm is picking up speed, putting the pressure on. Looks to take an apex jump. Does she land it? Looks like she's going to keep moving on. Megatron is knocked to the outside of turn one and recycled, but Blue Storm's also going to get knocked down on the outside of turn two.
Just hang on 1 second here. I think everything's all right. Yes. So that was four more points here, but they did get Tampa was able to score four on that beautiful apex jump by Blue Storm.
And that's the first points that Tampa has put up in a while.
Yes. Tampa's been held to 14 points so far this half, and I didn't see what the call was, but I do see the Tampa jammer sitting in the box.
All right, so we've got a power start for Poison Evie. Good jammer to put out there.
It's the fourth this half.
So whether this is just the power of the rotation that Evie's going to be out there, or if that was a planned maneuver there, but she's already picked up lead, not even 15 seconds into the jam.
Here we are at 92-122. This is the sixth lead in a row for Poison Evie.
Quick jump there of turn two. She'll put 4 points on the board to bring Tri-City to 96. Comes around a second time there. Blue Storm low out of the pack. It takes to the inside of turn two and completes an initial while Poison Ivy is being recycled. Outside of turn two, Poison Evie swings her hips around to the outside, calls it off, and is able to put up four, it looks like, additional points.
Yeah, and smartly the coach looks, eats up like the 2 seconds that he needed to get his other blocker out of the box. And so a blocker apiece in the box for each team.
All right, so Tampa scoreless, 122. Tri-City with 8 additional points on the board from Poison Evie. They are at 100, so 22 points. That's a big difference from where we were when we came into halftime here.
Yeah, this is the closest Tri-City has been to Tampa since the third jam.
Oh, wow. What a second half.
Yeah, 22 points, you know, is a blink of an eye. Tampa really able to secure lead there and really needed that momentum right there.
Yeah, so Tampa, who controlled lead so heavily in the first half, has brought it back to them here. Slamwich wearing the star, getting knocked out in turn one. We've got Animal, who's been good, aggressive, assertive, quick-moving, but unable to really make much progress here. Got the star off, looking to kind of hand it off there to Dangerous, who we've seen taking the star so many times, but just not in the right positioning between these two.
Yeah, and it's hard to, you know, it's important that your pivot be in a better position than you are as a jammer when you pass it, or at least attempt that. Yep. That's another scoring pass here for Slamwich. However,
yeah, 8 points so far for Slamwich with lead. We're under a minute on the jam clock right now. Pack is really stuck there in turn two. Slamwich is knocked out of bounds and pulled back to the jammer line.
And you know, I mean, I'm certainly not their coach, but Poison Ivy is just having such success. It might, you know, maybe run her every other because she seems to be a superhero.
All right, so Slamwich comes off the bench, answers everything that we've just talked about with a solid 12-point jam for Tampa. So that's going to bring Tampa to 134. Tri-City is going to take a timeout. They sit at 100, being held scoreless in that last jam. Just under 10 minutes left to go in the first game.
And I want to tell you that the WFTDA Continental Cups are brought to you by Radar Wheels, Radar Halo. Experience world-class edging. WFTDA Continental Cups, they support this broadcast that's coming to you with Radar and also Rydell. And Rydell skates the 2019 WFTDA Continental Cups are brought to you by the popular Rydell Solaris. The performance you demand, the comfort you've been missing.
And don't forget, I know we mentioned it as we came in from halftime, that game five today will be on Twitch and that will be live. So share that far and wide with anyone that you want to introduce to roller derby. In that last jam, it looks like, it doesn't look like, it is. Tampa Roller Derby has lost number nine, Wasilku, to seven penalties.
Yep.
So, and you know, we talked earlier about Tri-City sitting with a couple of blockers with four. They came into the second half with those two blockers with four penalties, and it stays there.
Yeah.
So they've been skating pretty clean. Right now we've got Rehab Reject taking a lead jammer for Tampa once again. Back-to-back leads here. We haven't seen that very often from Tampa in the second half.
But look at that beautiful move by Ashley DeVenny, putting four up on the board, passing. It would have been, maybe it would have been five in an old roller derby.
All right, so Ashley's going to pick up 2 points before that gets called off. We had Rehab Reject only picking up 3 points in her
So despite
trip.
Lead,
yep.
Tri-City still able to outscore Tampa in that jam. Tampa at 137, Tri-City at 106 with 8 minutes, well, actually just about 9 minutes yep. left.
And if you're just tuning in, welcome. Just to give you a quick recap, we have Tampa coming in, the 8th seed, taking on Tri-City, the number 9. That's ranked 52 versus 53. So we're expecting a lot out of this game. And it looks like the second half is definitely bringing it to us. We've got Felony Fat Bottom picking up lead once again for Tampa. I think it's the last three jams that they've been able to pick up lead. Not having the command in the second half like they did in the first.
Yeah.
Felony out with a quick 4-point trip.
Let's just be aware, though, there are three blockers in the box for Tri-City. One was just released. Two were just released. So now they're back to having at least some resistance.
Yes. And so we're seeing that here, Felony, with the quick scoring pass last time. This time, not so much. Having to work a little bit harder. But like a nice pirouette-type move out
beautiful.
Of turn two to put 4 points up.
And another, the same move twice. Wow, really beautifully done by Felony Fat Bottom there. And the star has been passed here to number 303.
Violet Noregard. Yep.
I think that's the second time that she has received the star.
Felony tries that same move on the inside of turn three. Doesn't work quite so well this
time. The third time, yeah.
But 13 points on for Tampa this time around. That's going to bring them to an even 150. Tri-City held scoreless at 106. We saw Tampa in the first half just, I don't
lock
know,
in.
Blow us away. Their defense was strong. They had a deep jammer bench. They were just getting things done. And Tri-City was really just not able to put things in place. And then we saw Tri-City come out of second half just so strong and collecting lead once again. And so now we've got Poison Ivy probably has the highest lead jammer percentage so far for them. And it's going to add to that right now coming out of turn one.
Big smile again. I think I think that is one of my favorite things. I also, part of the story of this second half is penalties, mm-hmm. and Tampa has had a lot of penalties, a lot of jammer penalties. I don't believe that Tri-City has given away one power jam.
Nope.
All right.
So that's huge.
Yeah, that is. Thanks to our producer, Andy Maroon, who's been giving us some great stats all game long. Doing such a great job. Neat handwriting, too. You can actually read it. I love it.
Okay. 6 minutes? Wow, that flew by. 6 minutes left. Tampa 150, Tri-City 109. Yes. Still plenty of time.
I feel like Tampa has really looked at the clock and been like, oh, man, things are going to be ending soon. We need to get back into it. And these last couple of jams, they've been able to pick up lead. They've been putting up some big points. And this time around, we've got Slamwich, who had a great jam the last time she was out there taking on Animal.
Both teams have definitely shrunk their jammer rotation in this second half. We've seen a lot of the same jammers going out, you know, every third.
Yep. So Animal taking a couple of repeated hits there to just kind of knock her out and recycle her.
Some offense being played by number 92 for Tampa. That's Tripp McNeely. And now the packs are so drawn out that we need to have some bridgers.
Yeah, really one from each team kind of poised and ready as things spread out.
So we are almost a minute into this jam without anybody securing lead. It reminds me of the first jam a little bit.
Yeah, absolutely. That we went a good minute and a half before we saw anything really come out of it. But Slamwich getting ever so closer to pick up lead, and she does.
That was hard fought, and you can see it. That was tiring, I would imagine.
So we've got the pack there in turn one, Slamwich coming into it. And it, just as she enters the pack, it really spreads out and kind of dissolves. So Slamwich with 4 points. That's going to add to Tampa's 150. So they're at 154 now. Tri-City still scoreless for a couple of jams here.
Yeah. It might not be a bad time for Tri-City. They do still have two timeouts left, Tampa with one. Both still have their official reviews for this half. Timeout is being called, of course, by Tri-City. Maybe I'm psychic. Maybe I'm smart. I don't know.
A combination of both.
So they're going to probably collect themselves and try and regroup, maybe actually, or give a rest to some of their more prolific jammers. Mm-hmm. So far, Poison Ivy has jammed 11 and secured lead for 7. That's a 64% lead percentage. And on the Tampa side, we still have Tink at 80. That's her. That's their highest lead percentage, but she only went in for 5 jams. We do have PH Diesel, who went took lead 5 out of 8 jams for 63%. And this is a 39-9 run for Tampa over the just the last 5 jams. So we're seeing the Tampa that we saw in the first half in the last 5-ish minutes.
Yeah, and you know, it's they're also just playing with a different intensity than we've seen. I think that they just kind of, you know, had a bit of a scare with Tri-City owning so much of the second half
getting
as it started.
22, yeah. Yep.
But now just Tampa realizes what's at stake here. If they want to move forward, they've got to get things done. So we've got Tink wearing the star for Tampa, starting right there on the jammer line, and it looks like Poison Ivy was trying to force a cut. But
definitely was trying to force a cut. It was not called, however.
So with that, Tink is out on an initial. Poison Ivy is out on an initial. Tink is coming in to score into turn one. She'll call it off as she approaches turn two. So, you know, you talked that kind of hit it and quit it, the putting the 4 points on. So here we are. Tink has put 4 points on the board. Tink has got 4 points. So Tampa's at 162. Tri-City scoreless. We were saying that a lot at the beginning of the second half about Tampa, and now just that has reversed, and we're seeing it more about Tri-City. So 162 to 109, 3.5 minutes. Bia, Sun City, you want to give us a quick sponsorship read?
I do. I want to tell you about S1 Helmets. S1 Lifer Helmet is the best fit and superior protection made for roller derby. Get a lifer, be a lifer.
All right, Megan Tran pushing the pack up front for Tri-City into turn one. She falls down. It kind of breaks up that two wall that was holding her back. It looks like she has picked up lead, though, in the process, but it's rehab reject with a quick hop.
Yeah, that was a hop, skip, and a jump to get out. Not lead, of course.
Yep, and so Megan Tran, with that lead, Jammer Povich, will go ahead and call it off before rehab reject is able to make too much of the track and potentially score some points for Tampa. So we've got an official timeout for Tri-City.
Yep.
It's a team timeout.
It's a team timeout, and it's their last team timeout. And it's, you know, we've got 2 minutes and 38 seconds left in this game. Not a bad idea. We're at 162 to 109. Both teams do still have their official reviews left. I would also like to tell you about Powerdyne plates and skate products. They're cutting-edge design and cutting-edge performance.
And always a reminder that game number five today, that'll be the game number five at 6 o'clock. That game will be broadcast live on Twitch, so you make sure that you check that out, share that with your friends, your family, your frenemies.
Yeah, if you love roller derby, share it.
Exactly.
Have a little watch party. That is the roundout whistle here, telling us that the timeout is over, but I do see, I believe, maybe an official review being called?
Yeah, it looks like we've got an official review for Tampa.
And if everything stays as it is, if Tampa takes this, as it looks like they may, they will be playing Naptown on Twitch, that game that you were just mentioning, at 6. So 6 o'clock, if Tampa stays in the lead here, it will be Tampa versus Naptown on Twitch. And Tri-City will be playing the loser of the Ohio and Madison tomorrow at 2.
All right, so Tri-City looking for a high block
on Megatron.
So we'll have that information for you just as soon as we can.
Is it Tri-City or is it Tampa? It's Tampa that's
Tampa,
looking
yeah,
for.
Yeah, was looking for it on Megatron. Yep.
Oh, what else can I tell you about? I'm sure there are many more things. WFTDA.tv, we will be bringing you continued coverage of the 2019 WFTDA postseason from the WFTDA Continental Cups through the International WFTDA Championships in November. Of course, those are held in Montreal. There are several different watch passes available at WFTDA.tv, so find one that suits you best and log in and join us live as the action unfolds. And it is unfolding right now. With only 2 minutes and 38 seconds left, we should let you know that the next game that's coming up is going to be Sailor City versus Toronto. They're doing some magic fingers from the Tri-City bench, trying to give some mojo to the official review.
Never hurts. Anything
review,
you can throw at it.
The officials have concluded that the call was not warranted. The official review will not be retained.
All right, so Tampa losing that official review. They have one team timeout remaining. Tri-City, though, on the other side of things, has exhausted all of their team timeouts and has that official review still out there. We've got Felony Fat Bottom wearing the star for Tampa in black, and that is Poison Ivy.
Little juke there to start things off. The box is empty.
Felony in the back of the pack. Ivy, who's been able to get out of the pack so quickly, so many times that she's worn the star. This time around, though, not so much. It's a slow trip into turn one.
Looking for both.
Yeah, looking to break out on the inside, but not able to make a pass there. It's a slow push. Pushing her shoulder in, trying to just break things up.
Yeah, well, sometimes I'll say, people are like, oh, roller derby. You know, do you punch people and stuff? I'm like, no, but we push 1,000 pounds
yeah.
of human
yes.
forward.
Yes. And, you know, the way that this is going to shake out here, we have Felony Fat Bottom picking up lead for Tampa. Poison Ivy with the star off, being knocked out of bounds the outside of turn one. Felony on a scoring pass, meeting a braced tripod of Tri-City blockers in turn two.
And Ivy has taken the star off of her helmet and is rightfully looking pretty tired. She's had a spectacular game. There is a Tampa blocker in the box for an entire minute. I'm not sure what the initial call was, but then there was an in-sub.
All right, so Felony Fat Bottom through for four, looking to score some additional points. Not too strong a pack out there for either team. Both jammers kind of split in the pack. Felony taking it to the inside and calling it off from the floor. She'll pick up two for a total of six. Poison Ivy, though, kind of flies out on the outside of turn three.
And that's the first points that that Tri-City has put up in quite some time.
So it looks like we've got an official review for Tri-City. This will be their final ability to stop the clock, but we are sitting at 57 seconds remaining on the period clock. So what a game.
Yeah, this
8-9 seed just like separated like 53-54 in 52-53 rather in ranking. And it's been a roller coaster.
It has been a roller coaster. It has not been one of those slow and steady games. It was Tampa out quick and fast and strong and defensive through the first half, pretty much. You know, they held.
Review, they're sinking a forearm call on black 357 jammer.
They held Tri-City scoreless, I think, about 10 minutes into the game. Mm-hmm. So, and then the second half, we saw Tri-City come out just as hard as Tampa did in the first half and just got lead and held jammers. Mm-hmm. And now we've seen Tampa sort of swing back into that commanding role. It would be interesting if the game was longer to see if Tri-City put another punch in there. But, of course, we only have 57 seconds left.
Yeah, the 22 points at one point where Tri-City really looked like they were poised to kind of potentially take the lead. And that's really when Tampa just put their foot down and said, not going to happen, and really kind of broke away with it.
Adam Smasher is coming over to tell us a little bit more about that official review.
And it looks like we'll probably get that from the house mic as well.
Yep.
After review, the officials do not have additional information that would warrant the call. The review will not be retained.
All right, so there we go. No additional clock stoppages for Tri-City. Tampa is at 168, Tri-City 113, 57 seconds on the period clock.
There are two blockers in the box here for Tampa and one for Tri-City. It would be quite a feat to score the nearly 50 points needed.
You bend that time-space continuum and everything is possible. Poison Ivy lead once again for Tri-City. But also out is PH Diesel for Tampa. The pack is moving.
Yeah. Moving.
Evie's going to take it to the outside of turn three. Gets knocked out of bounds. by
no points.
Can't get the by number 83. Break some bones. A well-timed hip there to take Evie out. So as you said, no points. Now 23, 22, 21.
Yeah, we'll see what happens here. If there will be an additional jam.
So Tampa sitting at 168.
Tri-City is certainly hoping so.
Yep. All right, there we go. That whistle. Tink coming in from the back. And it is Megantron putting lead back on the checklist for Tri-City.
What a way to end. That, you know, that's going to give them a little bit of confidence here going into, of course, this is a tournament weekend. Mm-hmm. So,
so it looks like Tink has taken the star off or it got knocked off. That was sitting there on the track for a bit.
It's still sitting there, I believe.
All right, so Megantron has picked up lead, looking to put some points in there for Tri-City. Not being able to move out of turn two to pick up points.
Roller derby turned, capture the flag. That's what that reminded me of when the star was on the floor.
All right, so just stagnant to pack there in turn two. Megantron not able to find an opportunity to get out with that lead jammer privilege kind of at her hands.
Yeah, and right now it's just about points. And remember, the more points you can score, it does impact your rankings. That's four right there for Megantron to bolster my...
And Tink being sent to the penalty box on a cut. So we are on jam time, only 40 seconds left. We've got Megantron through for an additional 4 points.
That's eight on the jam here, 121 to 168. And I feel like this is just bringing my point back about if this game was longer, it seems like that shift has happened again. Tri-City has some momentum.
D-Ride, well positioned there to take Megantron to the infield there. Last time Megantron tried to complete the pass, but now just really stuck in the middle of it. Slow as molasses, not able to move forward. She is just surrounded there and eventually pushed to the outside.
I think, if I had to guess, I think Megantron did have four in the pocket, yes.
Yep, absolutely. So she'll end on an 8-point jam. What a game. So unofficial final. Tampa at 168, Tri-City 125. And I know that we've done a recap so many times here in the second half, but it was just so worth discussing. And if you came in late, we didn't want you to miss out on what had happened so far. It was pretty incredible. Tampa came out so strong in the first half with seven jammers out there at any given, well, not at any given time, but during the course of the first half, and just dominated, picked up lead. Their defense was strong, just held Tri-City to scoreless jam after scoreless jam. And then we kind of came into that second half. And kind of give me a recap there, Beanie.
Yeah, and then the second half, Tri-City came out just as strong, and they chipped and chipped and chipped away at that Tampa lead, bringing it all the way down to 22 points, I believe was the closest they ever got. But really showed some great character in being able to come back, and showed that character again sort of towards the end. Just to tell you about Tampa's defense, Tampa gave away 8 power jams to Tri-City and still won this game. Tri-City gave away no power jams to Tampa. So that just tells
incredible.
A little bit of the story of Tampa's defense today.
Yep.
It was incredible.
So up next, we have game two of the weekend. That's going to be Toronto Roller Derby taking on Sailor City Rollers. Toronto coming in the 12 seed and Sailor City the number 5. So you don't want to miss that. That will be starting at noon. And don't forget the Twitch game.
Yeah.
Game
for
number
free.
5 at 6 o'clock. All right. So thanks so much for joining us. This first game of the 2019 WFTDA North American Cup East, live from Lancaster, Pennsylvania, brought to you by the Dutchland Derby Rollers and the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. My name is Alota Sarcasm.
I'm B. Nimble. Thanks for watching.
Andy.